This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to talk about finding the least common multiple of two numbers. So let's start with the numbers 6 and 15 and try to understand what this is about. I'm going to make a list of multiples of 6. So 1 times 6 is 6, 2 times 6 is 12, 3 times 6 is 18, 4 times 6 is 24, 5 times 6 is 30, 6 times 6 is 36, and my list could keep going. And I'll make a list of multiples of 15. So 1 times 15 is 15, 2 times 15 is 30, 3 times 15 is 45, 4 times 15 is 60, and that list could keep going too. Now, if I'm looking for a common multiple, it means I'm looking for a multiple that's in both of my lists. And both of my lists have 30s in them. There's no other multiple in the list, so far it looks like that would be the smallest common multiple I've got. It would be the least common multiple. Now notice if I continued my list, especially the one for the 6, if I got down to 10 times 6, then I would have had a 60. So 60 is a multiple of 6. And 60 is also on my list for the 15. But it's not the smallest multiple they have in common. It's not the least multiple. That would be the 30. Okay, so 30 is the least common multiple of 15. If I want to write that in notation, I'm going to write LCM for least common multiple. In parentheses, I'll write 6, 15. So the least common multiple of 6 and 15 is 30. Okay, now, this list method will work, but as your numbers get bigger, it gets to be a lot of work, a lot of multiplication. So here's a much faster way to do it. I'm going to make a prime factorization for each of the numbers 6 and 15, so I'll do a factor tree. So 6 is, well, that's easy, that's just 2 times 3. And actually, 15 is easy too. 15 factors down into 3 times 5, and now I've got nothing but prime numbers. 2 times 3 for the 6, and 3 times 5 for the 15. Now, if I'm looking for multiples of 6, any multiple of 6 is going to have a 2 and a 3 as some of its factors. So I know that the least common multiple of 6 and 15 would have to contain both a 2 and a 3. So I can start out writing that the LCM of 6 and 15 is 2 times 3. Now I'm not done. As far as the 15 is concerned, any multiple of 15 is going to have a 3 as a factor and a 5 as a factor. Now, as I'm looking for the LCM, the least common multiple, I already know I need a 2 and a 3. So I've taken care of this 3 that's also in the 15. But my least common multiple has to have a 5 as well. So I'm going to say that the least common multiple of 6 and 15 would be 2 times 3 times 5. If we look at this 2 times 3 times 5, we realize we've got the 2 and the 3 that's in the factorization of 6. And we've got the 3 and the 5 that's in the factorization of 15. And then all I would have to do is multiply 2 times 3 times 5, and that would equal 30. Okay, let's do another one. So let's see. I want to do 12 and 90. So I want the least common multiple of 12 and 90. So I'll factor 12 down into its prime factorization. Let's see, 12 is 3 times 4, and 4 is 2 times 2. So 12 is 2 times 2 times 3. And 90, I'll factor that down into 9 times 10. And 9 is a composite, that's 3 times 3. 10 is also a composite. That's 2 times 5. So my prime factorization for 90 would be 2 times 3 times 3 times 5. And now if I'm looking for the least common multiple, so let's see, the LCM of 12 and 90 would equal, let's look at the 12. Well, the 12 has to have two twos and a three. Any multiple of 12 will contain two twos as well as a three. So I can put in that the LCM of 12 and 90 equals 2 times 2 times 3. But I'm not done because I have to look over at the 90. Well, a multiple of 90 has to contain a 2. I've already got that written here on my list. It has to have two 3s. I've only got one 3 in my list, so I'll need another one. And it has to have a 5. So let's check that. The 12 has to have a 2, a 2, and a 3. And I've got two 2s and a 3 in my LCM. The 90 has to have a 2, 3, 2, 2, 3s, and a 5. And I've got that. So it looks like my least common multiple of 12 and 90 will be 2 times 2 times 3 times 3 times 5. If I multiply those together, let's see, 2 times 2 is 4, 4 times 3 is 12, 3 times 12 is 36, and 36 times 5 is 180. So my LCM of 12 and 90 is 180. Okay, once again, all I did was I broke the numbers down into their prime factorizations. Then I built the least common multiple by taking all of the numbers in the prime factorization for one of the numbers, the 12. And then I looked at the numbers in the prime factorization for the other number, the 90, and added those to my list, anything that wasn't already in the list. I checked the list to make sure I had everything from the 12, the 2, and the 3, and everything from the 90, the 2, 2 3s, and a 5. And then I just multiply all those factors together. Okay? Let me just do one more quick one to make a point. So let's say we've got 21 and 10. We break those down into their prime factorization. So 21 is 3 times 7, and 10 is 2 times 5. Now, if I want to make the LCM, the least common multiple, of 21 and 10, I need a 3 and a 7, and I need a 2 and a 5. I haven't got a 2 and a 5 on my list yet, so I also need a 2 and a 5. So I've got a 3 and a 7 from the 21, 2 and a 5. You notice there's no overlap in the factors of 21 and 10. Because these numbers are what we call relatively prime. They're not prime numbers, but they have no prime factors in common. They're called relatively prime. And actually, when that happens, what we've got is just the product of the two numbers. So we could say that the least common multiple is going to be 21 times 10, or 3 times 7, which is 21, times 2 times 5, which is 10, and 21 times 10, or 3 times 7 times 2 times 5, is 210. So if you see the two numbers are relatively prime, all you have to do is multiply those two numbers together to get the least common multiple. Okay, that's it for this one. Take care, and I'll see you next time.